white sauce pasta, which is Alfredo sauce. This is a vegan version of the Alfredo sauce. And for that today, we are going to be using almond milk. And I've put it in a cup. I'm not sure how much I'm going to need. So I've just put it in the cup, and I also have the bottle just in case I need more. We're going to use vegan butter, grapeseed oil. I tend to use grapeseed oil or avocado oil, but you can use any oil that you have in the house. And you can also change this from vegan to a vegetarian recipe by using regular butter. This is Daiya cheese. It's vegan mozzarella cheese. 2 teaspoons of salt. 4 cloves of garlic shredded. About a half a teaspoon of black pepper, because you're not making it spicy and the kids are going to eat it. Chopped fresh basil. And I have about 2 big spoons of flour, and this is spelt flour. You can use white flour or you can use wheat flour. Either one can work as well. Okay, so we're going to get started. About 2 teaspoons of oil. And this is about 2 tablespoons of vegan butter. We're just going to let it melt a little bit. Okay, so you want your butter to be completely melted. I'm going to lower the heat a little bit. Now I'm going to add the garlic. Just fry it for a couple seconds. Alfredo usually is just cheese and cream sauce, but I don't use that. So what we're going to do now is we're going to put the flour in, and you want to make sure the flour actually is even proportion to the oil. So you can actually see, and you want to constantly mix so it should not look dry. See how it still looks liquidy. And this is just a thickener that is going to make our sauce nice and thick and also give it a very creamy feel. We want this to get nice and pink. I think we can still add a little bit more. So remember, it needs to stay liquidy, okay? Do not let it be dry. You just want it to become kind of pinky-ish in color. While this is going on, I am going to throw in my basil as well as my pepper. And now it smells so delicious already. Now I'm going to put in, we're going to do this slowly because we want this to mix. We're going to add our milk. And you want to mix while you mix. I'm making it. Continuously mix. Add more. Okay. Because you don't want lumps. There should be no lumps. So I think I'm going to add a little bit more milk, about a cup should go. Okay, so I'm going to add more milk to this, and then we're going to let it cook for about 5 to 7 minutes. It's going to start thickening because of the flour that we have in it. So this is about, I would say about 4 cups of milk, okay, in here. I'm also going to throw in my salt. I have boiled a packet and a half of farfalle, and I also put some broccoli in it, which I've just blanched in the same water. So I have put 2 teaspoons because I've made a good amount of sauce. If you want to, you can half the recipe and just do like one packet and all the ingredients just half done, okay? So you want to constantly stir. You do not want it to stick at the bottom. And you want it, you can see it's already thickening for me. A few more minutes. You want to continue stirring until it's good and nice and thick. Do it on slow, or medium heat. Please stay with it. Do not leave it unattended, because it is milk, and milk tends to boil over. A few more minutes and this will be ready. Now, this is an option. If you don't want to put cheese, you can actually enjoy the sauce exactly the way it is. Right now, this tastes so delicious. But I'm going to add cheese. Because my kids love it cheesy. So we're going to put mozzarella cheese in here. I'm going to continue stirring until it's all melted and delicious. See, it's already starting to melt. Okay, so this is the consistency of the sauce, see? How delicious that looks. And here I have my pasta with the broccoli. It's ready. I'm just gonna pour the sauce in the pan, because this pan is bigger than my saucepan, so I cannot transfer the pasta into it. It over here. I'm just gonna mix it all together. And our pasta Alfredo is ready to eat. Look at how delicious that looks. I'll do a taste test. I'm glad you like it. Thank you for watching my video. If you enjoyed this video, please share, like, and subscribe. Also, turn on the notification bell so you're notified when I do a new video. And I hope you enjoy this recipe. If you do it. If you make the recipe, please leave a comment. I'd like to know what you thought of it. Thank you so much. Love you guys.